surrender.
I guess the one who was hiding left. Or left hiding to attack us. Well, we got goodies. Stop. Yay! For goodies. Battle axe. Six shins.
On it.
Eight shins and a spray flesh. Sweet. I think that's this... yeah, it's going there.
Ready.
20 shins and another battle axe. Those will sell for a paltry sum.
Yes, now.
Well, they won't sell for a paltry sum now, when we sell them. 9 shins and a battle axe.
Ready.
49 shins, a hyper-elutriated force, regular version, and a greatsword. Now that we have here. Or hyper-elutriated? I don't remember which one we picked up, actually. I think we just picked up regular elutriated.
Yes.
And 4 shins and another battle axe. That's interesting, though. Oh, there's someone dead over there. How do I... where? Oh, on a leg? I have to click on the leg? This dead woman bears numerous stab wounds, probably inflicted by the predatory echoes that seem to infest the gullet. Judging by the scrawled maps and notes that are stuffed among her things, she may have been an explorer or a bloom guide. It looks as though her belts and pouches are mostly intact. Yeah, they don't care for, you know, to loot things. They just have rage. They just want to fight, kill. It's about a simple-minded rage. Search the corpse. We got an obedient rope. Which is an artifact. Good, not a cipher. You kneel down next to the corpse and let your trained eyes rove across her body. Here a pouch seems to bulge, and your hand dips in and returns with a handful of shins. There a pocket lies flat, and you ignore it. You realize that the guide's belt is no such thing. It's a length of synth rope, about 15 meters long, and as you touch it, it uncoils from her waist, almost as if it were responding to your need. It coils itself toward you, and you place it among your possessions. Obedient rope. Made from some type of synth material, the rope is 15 meters in length, and looks sturdy and strong. As you hold it, it squirms gently in your hands, trying to wrap itself around your wrists. It appears to possess a rudimentary form of intelligence, perhaps even sentience. It can tie and untie itself on command. Sweet. Search again. You don't find anything else of value. Search again. 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 Okay, I'm done. Poor lady. Can't zoom in anymore. Can't do anything with it right now. It is an artifact, though. Is this something we can put on? No. Okay. The reef of bone is almost beautiful. Perhaps these are the skeletal remnants of the bloom's victims, transformed by the bloom for some purpose of its own. Got some kind of loot over here. 37 shins, a hyper-elutriated force, that's the better one, and a black stone rings oddity. This curious object is a pair of linked rings made of a black stone-like substance. Together they are solid, the size of a clenched fist, but they can be disjointed and connected again, each time reforming into perfect circles. Use? So freaking loud. This curious object consists of a pair of heavy-linked rings made of a black stone-like substance. Locked together, they appear completely solid, roughly the size of a clenched fist. The rings are large enough to fit around a human wrist. Inspect the rings. Regarding them more closely, it strikes you that these are not two separate rings, but rather two representations of the same ring. Putting your ear to them, you hear a slight hum of transdimensional power. You feel like they could be useful somehow, though it's not immediately apparent what that use might be. The rings hum with transdimensional power, one simply a representation of the other. Before I pull them apart, let's try to discern the function of these rings. Oh, I got a cipher. Damn it. It turned into a cipher. After some time experimenting with locking and unlocking the rings, you confirm they are two representations of one whole, and the energies they share can be used to transmit matter. The most obvious way to use these would be to wear them as bracelets. The question of activation is one of more experimentation. After poking, prodding, and rubbing the bracelet in various ways, you find it can be activated by squeezing it in a certain spot. Doing so will swap the positions of the two people wearing these bracelets. Oh, really? That's cool. That could be helpful in certain circumstances. So, yeah, now they're called traitor's rings. Swap positions with a target ally. Completely refills the health of both target and caster. Huh. Well, even if we don't need to trade positions, it can refill our health, so that's another function. This thing's pretty cool. This curious object is a pair of linked rings made of black stone-like substance. Together they are solid, the size of a clenched fist, but they can be disjointed and connected again, each time reforming into perfect circles. Whatever their original purpose, similar objects were once commonly used as a means of infiltrating well-guarded places and temples. This should be our lore, I think. It should say lore there. Particularly in assassination attempts, an assassin and a willing accomplice, usually a bribe servant or a scheming advisor, would each wear one of a pair as an easily concealed armband. When one wearer squeezed his hand firmly, the two conspirators would immediately swap places. Oh, let's not use that. Yeah, if I use it, it's gone, so... I'll give it the time here. Okay. Just so I don't have two things overcoming me. Alright. He's like coming. Should we mess with this thing some more? I'm not gonna go through it. In fact, I'm gonna save just to make sure. Return.
Let's go.
From a bloated sphincter in the wall, a vile mix spews into the room, flowing down into the pool. It smells like a foul coupling of sewage and vomit. Ooh. The white synth egg? Well, I don't think there's any use for that thing anymore, so why not? We'll try that instead of the sealant bomb. The sealant bomb might be useful for something else. Plug the sphincter with the white synth egg. I can go to 100. Ow. I took 1 damage. The egg is almost exactly the right size to shove into the orifice. Ugh. You force it into the opening, spraying bloom juice in all directions. It hisses and burns when it hits your bare skin, but you ignore the pain, shoving the egg deeper until the flow of liquid has stopped. The sphincter convulses once or twice but your makeshift seal holds firm. The level of the pool drops as one of its sources is cut off.
Going.
Your impromptu plug appears to be holding. The sphincter makes wheezing, burbling sounds, but nothing else comes out. And this thing we mess with too.
Yes, now.
We tied it up. Right, we looked at that. And now this thing. The juices, also coming from here. This place is so disgusting.
Going.
Three fat arteries converge under a bridge of bloom flesh, spilling a foul, sludgy mess from the other side. It empties into the pool and spirals down into an open sphincter. Use the sealant spray to block the flow of liquid. Use the sealant bomb to block the opening. Which one should we do? Let's see if I can get a hint from description. Because we could probably use one of these for something else then. There's the spray. Permanently close a medium-sized aperture or hole. It is too delicate for usage in combat. So when else are we going to need to close a medium-sized aperture or hole? Again, cover and seal a hole. The bomb might be more effective, because this looks bigger than medium. This looks like the size of a human, but again, I mean, define medium.
Right.
Use a sealant bomb to block the opening. You drop the metal orb into the opening and it explodes, stopping the flow of bile with a blob of instantly hardened synth. The blocked arteries swell and bulge, but they show no immediate sign of rupture. The last bit of liquid in the pool drains out. There's a hole at the bottom, a new entry into a lower chamber. Now you just need to find a way down. Now that the opening has been blocked, the flow of disgusting bile has stopped. And we look like that. Okay, before I go down there,
without a doubt,
we need to check out this maw.
Go.
Hello there, maw. How are you doing today? The flesh of this maw is dark, dark and scabrous. It keeps itself tightly shut, like the puckered mouth of an ancient crone. You can hear its voices, and they are unusually sharp, almost painful to hear. You know what? Before I do anything, we can sleep for free in this thing. So let's do that.
Of course.
Of course. You glance over at Callistes. She raises her hand in silent, yielding acceptance.
That's more like it!
Awesome. Just checking to make sure this is not having any obvious effect on us. Oh yeah, the fibrous bar I wanted to look at.
Yes.
Is that... Oh wait, I'm not on him. Wait. Okay, plus two might pull. Are there any other bonded artifacts that we can use? Because we have a spot for some of them. That's an ornament. Does everyone have ornaments? Tiber doesn't have one. It's a flex skill. Plus one training. I guess I can hold on to it for me, but see if there's anything else. Share all fennels and 25% of stats healed. Well, we have stuff already. Ornaments. So we don't need two, just one. Hardest prison. Plus one training level in perception skill. Takes away from stealth skill. He doesn't need that. It's an oddity. Cloak. I'm just gonna give it to him because we might be able to use that. Thinker's cap. Plus one intellect edge. He doesn't have a use for that. Oddity, oddity. Ornament. Is that what he's missing? Ornament? He's missing ornament. Where was I? Here? Thinker's cap? Plus one intellect edge. But minus two intellect pool. Yeah, I don't like that. I was looking at this. Oh. Yeah. Frost Brooch. Four resistance deals five chemical damage to enemies entering or starting their turn in immediate range. That is for you, my man. Unless we want to give him the Shadow Ring. I'll throw that over here too, and we'll decide. We'll deliberate. This is a great sword. He has a cloak. Four resistance, five chemical damage. Four resistance, same. Two relativistic damage. I'm gonna use this for him. Bloop. It made the noise quieter. Hmm. I'll give that back to myself. And everyone has a cloak? What kind of cloaks do we have? Wait. He's got Tiber's mantle. Oh, cannot be unequipped. Damn it, So the only thing is it's two resistance. Spirit Shroud. Yeah, he can't use two armor, three resistance. This only confers plus 15% evasion. I mean, helpful, but... it helps with our movement speed, too, and she's slow. So... she's gonna wear the feather cloak then. Look at that. Made of feathers. At least they're better looking than a Murden's feathers. Saving again. Because, you know, Maw. We don't know what the hell's gonna happen. Listen carefully to the voices of the Maw. The voices spit and hiss, their meaning unclear but undeniably cruel. Still, you don't get the sense that the Maw's ire is directed at you. It doesn't seem to react to your presence at all. Which means it doesn't want me, right? You detect nothing new in the voices. They are still harsh and malevolent and utterly indifferent to your presence. Observe the behavior of the Maw's tongues. The tendrils wave gently through the air, torpid and aimless. They don't seem interested in anything nearby. Observe the behavior of the Maw's tongues. Again. Nope, okay. Cut it open with a transdimensional scalpel. Oh my god. The whole thing shook, and red tide raised a moderate amount. You thrust the scalpel into the tough, fibrous flesh of the maw and begin to saw through its puckered mouth. It gives way easily, and the Bloom's voices respond with a shriek of rage. Skin tears, gristle snaps, and the maw opens. And where's it go? This is how we find out. It goes to the Chamber of Bones, and that goes to the nethermost cavity. It's kind of a strange place, speaking of time-wise, to cut off, so I'm just gonna go into the bones? The Chamber of Bones. Let's check it out. Hello? Corpuscular Maw. This is an area we couldn't get to otherwise. We got some goodies here.
Let's go.
40 shins and a refined Fleetfoot Moss. And yeah, just to add to my refined Fleetwood Mac collection. My Fleetfoot Moss collection. We got here. Towering before you stands a massive rib bone with most of the flesh eaten away. Well, I can't go this way. We're gonna deal with these corpuscular maw things. We can talk to them or something. Oh, a crisis. It's not happy. Because we chopped the thing open. I mean, what do we expect? What does Tiber want to do? I don't think we want to use any of his... he's got a new one. Oh, swap positions and heal. 28 transdimensional damage. All in immediate area. All characters, which will hurt us as well, I'm supposing. Should I get a plus 20 armor? I might as well use this stuff. I can't help but think I'm gonna wish that I hadn't used certain things.
All right.
Heh, like that, huh? Okay. Just gonna get up and close. This thing. I've got really awesome armor. Eritus. Counters negative fettles, blah blah. Changing to. Okay, he's just gonna attack. I'm glad we slept before we did this. What happened?
I'm making a dent over here.
Well, you weren't attacking.
I'm making a dent over here.
Perfect. You mean they're not making a dent? He got thrown over here? What the hell are you doing over there? Alright. Me? Is it my turn? Okay, let's go. Refill stat pools, 30 points of health, we're fine. Yeah, I'm just gonna attack. You know, I gotta check Codex after this, see if there's anything added. If there was, I didn't notice, so... yeah, I'm just attacking. That's pretty neat, though. Incite action, so Tyber can make another attack. Choose an enemy as well. Yeah, just the same.
Never felt better than I do right now.
That's good. In the heart of combat. Alright. Calistee is all the way back there. These things don't have possessions, so I think that would be a waste. I'm gonna have her attack this time. When we need to heal, we'll use those tablets. Yeah, never mind. Can I reach with this thing? I want to make sure he's not... Can I... Tiber's gonna get stuck in it. Flash. I have a feeling Tiber will get stuck in this too. Or isn't this only enemies? Hold on. Flash is only enemies. At least according to that.
Another one just...
Nice. Oh, look at all that green slime. Ew. Catch up a little. Huh. Barely scratched him. Ditto. It does two different kinds of damage, apparently. It's not giving us fettles, is it? This one is more damaged.
Nothing can stop me now.
Cuz I'm the Duke of Earl.
My attack didn't feel strong at all. At all.
Well, you did kill it. Somehow Tyber got knocked over here. Is that because of the ring? No, that's that. Who has that ring? It's an ornament. I don't know. I think it's something in this area that's knocking us around. Either that or a bug in the game. Who the hell knows?
Find him! Something to do!
Yeah, all you're doing is running up. Uh-oh. These things are barely damaging us. Not that I'm complaining, mind you. flash.
Surrender.
That hardly did any damage. I got it's something going on over here. I mean, sure, I can be over there. I'm out of range of that thing. That's why Eretus can deal with it. She's cool. Alright, so this... We're not really damaged. And we don't have Fettles, as far as I know. We're she's flanked. Oh, active entire crisis. So even if you're not flanked anymore... You still have the Fettle. That doesn't make any sense. It's only be while you're flanked. Can I hit just these two guys? I think so. Whoa. Okay, we destroyed one. Or another one. That's the last one? Cool. It missed. You're doomed. Let's do a sucker punch, I guess. Oh, look at that. Limits of human capacity. Look at that. I guess I forgot he had this. Plus 25% movement speed, plus 5 initiative, plus 1 max effort, and plus 15% on all tasks. Lasts until next sleep. Sucker punch.
Not really. But you killed it.